Hello, and welcome back to my Total War Warhammer 2 Let's Play as a Greenskin. So we are picking up where we left off, trying to finish this war against the Skaven. We will send Warzak this way, because I don't think this place will continue rebelling soon, because we're building our public order building. And so let's just improve our economy with the money that we have. Want to improve this? And okay, that's all we can do. That's all we can do this turn. So next turn we will put this place under siege and wait for them to sally out. Because as you can see here, the walls are too powerful. Those are lizardmen towers. They'll destroy us. These here are also Skaven towers, so they'll destroy us as well. So we gotta wait. So we have to put everything under siege. Then once we conquer Dread Rock, we will do Azak's quest battle, which is a very easy quest battle. It's a very easy and actually quite boring quest battle, but you'll see which one it is. I thought it would be one of the more fun ones, but no. Oh, it is this one here, and that's just against peasants. So, the new Wood Elf DLC is going to be released soon. I don't know if I'm actually going to buy that DLC. I will, however, do a High Elf campaign when the new DLC is released. I don't know if I'll play as Alariel or as Imric. I'll decide that when the DLC comes out, because apparently I've heard that it'll change something about Alariel as well. So, oh, it has some changes to the Tree Spirits and Alariel, from what I've heard. So I want to see if it actually changes anything about Alariel, because that would be interesting. Yeah, I might also actually do a Skaven campaign, but I don't know if I'm gonna buy the DLC. It's not as if the Skaven DLC would actually affect any of the units that I wouldn't actually affect the way I play a Skaven campaign, because I don't actually use any of those units. I mostly use weapons teams. I mostly use weapons teams, and every time I play as Skaven, I play as Ikid Claw. Also, I don't really know if that would actually affect the way I play as Skaven. It'll definitely affect the multiplayer and some other people's campaigns, but I just don't really see those units as being very, very useful. Well, they're just more giant monsters. They're pretty vulnerable to archers, as in are not as powerful as rattling guns are, especially if you don't have the Lore of Life. If giant monsters really seem to require the Lore of Life in order to be useful. Let's send Warzak down here.
Mork says what?
No.
Let's hope that Skarsnik doesn't get ambushed, and that he manages to actually ambush someone. And let's end our turn. There's nothing else we can do. We need to finish off the Skaven, capture the Dragon Isles, and then attack the. They sailed out to us. And then we will have to attack the Empire in order to win the campaign. Shouldn't be too difficult. We should be able to very easily destroy all of their cities, because their towers aren't all that good, and our Squeakhoppers should probably be capable of dealing with their Hellstorm rocket batteries, plus Empire infantry. Well, actually, all human infantry in this game really lets you down a lot. But they're all disappointing. I think every human infantry unit is disappointing. When compared to the dwarves, the orcs and the elves, they just seem to be better at fighting in melee, or actually fighting in melee, fighting with fighting with ranged weapons, or they just all... Actually, the humans seem to be pretty bad at everything. Except artillery and cavalry. Those are the only things they seem to be good at. Everything else they suck at. Are they all hidden? They are. Not sure how the elves are not gonna notice them. I'm just hiding these trees. They probably smell terrible. They'll then make a hell of a lot of noise. Is but okay. They have artillery back there. We want to send our cavalry to deal with their artillery soon. Look at this blob. If only he could fly, we could drop a purple son of Zarius right here. We don't have Skull Muncher yet. Yeah, we don't have Skull Muncher yet. What a shame. Okay, hit that Charybdis, please. And go zap that Charybdis, please. Yeah, they have some cavalry right there. The Cold One Dread Knights. They do count as monsters. No, they don't count as monsters cavalry, do they? No, they're just cavalry. Not like the new Great Stag Knights. That did some pretty good damage. Yeah, it did some pretty decent damage. We need to be careful with these harpies before they could destroy our artillery if we're not careful. We don't want to reveal our cavalry just yet. And we want to wait for them to move a bit further so that we can then intercept their artillery and destroy it. Okay, that attack completely missed. Not that it was going to do much damage even if it hit. Okay, yeah, you should probably go defend the artillery. Okay, charge into melee. We're the Grain Tide. We want to buff up our units and send him into melee as well. Okay, good. They're in melee now. Go shoot the. Actually, no. Shoot the Charybdis. Not Charybdis. Hydra. Okay, we're taking damage. We want to buff up our units. Good, we've obliterated those guys. Shoot the witch elves, please. Actually, no, keep shooting the monsters. You should probably go and try and catch the witch elves. Okay, yeah, good. Now, their artillery just isn't moving. Oh well. Their mistake. They're gonna get obliterated now by the. Bouncing balls of doom. Actually, what do you call those in English? Those rubber balls that you throw on the ground and they just bounce around the place? Is there? So I always thought those things were super fun when I was a kid. And I don't know what they're called though. Oh damn! Witch elves are fighting both the goblins and the orcs. Okay, good, they're starting to send some black art against minions. This is not good. And he went berserk. Okay, let's buff him up again. Yep, want two of them to go that way. And these two, I want them to go this way and kill the archers. Ah, damn it, they're in melee. They managed to get into melee with our artillery. As I feared. Good, good, we've won there. Actually, no, stand still. Don't move forward. Keep taking damage. All of you guys just halt and keep doing what you're doing. Keep getting shot. Okay, run away from the witch elf lady. There we go. Okay, I'll charge forward. Good, the Blackguard got stuck back there. Attack bells, artillery weapons. Damn it, one of our artillery weapons ran away. Oh no no.
What?
We still have both artillery weapons. I thought both of them ran away, but I thought one of them had run away, but nope. Okay, that's bad. We need money. Not money, we need our spells. Kill that thing before it can kill us. Where's our wizard? We need another foot of cork. Bring our archers. No, these guys can keep shooting. These guys are closer. Come on, we want to use a... damn it, I can't select them. We need a fanatics over here. This is a pretty tough fight, man. Good, good, their artillery is gone. Yeah, it's been wiped out. Rear charge, please.
Show us the enemy.
Okay. Yeah, we can't use that yet. We should probably get Azog out of this fight. Don't let Azog die. Get Azog out of that fight. Die for Azog! Damn it, they're not doing too good. Send our squid compass that way.
Gonna cast spells.
Yeah, cast a spell right here. Oh no, right there. Smash them.
Field of power.
This is a pretty tough fight. Dark Elf. Yeah, Dark Elf infantry is no joke. Elven infantry is no joke compared to human infantry. Okay, we win. Nobody got wiped out, I'm sure. I'm pretty sure that nobody got wiped out. But damn, this was a tough fight. I mean, we didn't have almost anything to use in this fight. We basically just ran into melee. And yeah, Black Orcs, especially at this high level and with all the technology, can obviously beat Black Guard. Not sure if... yeah, but Blackguard sure does a number on him. Or at the very least holds him off for long enough for their archer units to deal real damage. Which is probably most likely what actually happened. The archer units did most of the damage. He doesn't regenerate yet. So, no overcasting. Come on, we gotta wipe him out. Are those guys wiped out? Those guys are wiped out. We gotta wipe out as many units as we can. Are these guys just standing there? That's not good. Go wipe out those guys. Those guys are 48. Please wipe them out. Are they wiped out? Oh, okay. Stop shooting. Stop shooting. You're just causing casualties at this point. You're doing more harm than good at this point. Okay, good, good. We've caught up to them. They're wiped out. Cavalry is so good for running down enemy units that are fleeing, so we don't have to deal with them later. Okay, those guys escaped. Not good. Let's not let these guys escape. Okay, this Blackguard truly can't decide where to run. For extremely well trained. And super high elite infantry, they sure do run on pretty easily. Nah, actually, those guys are almost unbreakable. They're pretty tough to break, which makes sense because they're super elite infantry that have been trained for centuries. It's basically since birth, they have to become Black Guards. Okay, we wiped out two monsters. Yes. One is so badly damaged it doesn't even count as being alive anymore. And yeah, that one basically survived by very little. Most of their army is gone, the artillery is gone, nobody got wiped out.
We made poor slaves.
Yeah, Dark Elves, you make poor slaves, but you do make good dinner. We make poor slaves, but good dinner. Mmm, pointy-head roast. Ooh, no wait, roasted pointy-head. Sautéed pointy-head. What's the best way to prepare pointy-heads, I wonder? Probably one of those questions that doesn't need to be answered. And it's all too complex for normal greenskins to do anyway. Leave the complex cooking thing to Grom. Oh, hi, wood elves. Yeah, that's a pretty scary army, I guess. Oh, it's Daith! This is scary that the Empire is raiding my places. Okay, yeah, we win. Okay, yeah. No, if we attack, we'll take way too many casualties, so... whatever. Didn't occupy. Oh, look, they're roasting the Dark Elf for us. Yeah, the Dark Elf funeral. Oh, they went through the effort of roasting the Dark Elf for us. Good. Yeah, we want that guy. 3 turns, which is about what it takes us to replenish. Skull Muncher, we need that. Eh, he's not immortal yet. That's bad. What do we want? Not. Okay, I thought they were going to attack us, but no, they didn't. So, Snitch is now outside the settlement.
No, I blame you. You who
needs so, I got an idea.
Sounds like a good idea.
Quick, not quick. Skarsnik will put it under siege. Like so.
Stick him!
Skarsnik actually has lightning strike, but that's not what we're going to do. We're just going to put it under siege with Skarsnik, and then Grimgor will attack the Deathmaster Snitch. Yeah, like that, and then we just auto-resolve and obliterate him. Should I? Yeah, let's see here. That was a bit of excessive damage. Ridiculously excessive damage. We'll take the food.
They're dead! Knife
them. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, that will help when ambushing. But we really need to get the proper tough. We want this guy to be better at, I don't know, all his useful spells already learned. Sneaky stabbing will help. We want more health, yeah, so she doesn't die that easily.
Ready for murdering.
More speed. Edbert, we might need that.
No!
And now... it's a pretty big army still in there. Maybe we should try and build some siege equipment.
Make 'em bleed.
That's what more.
Yeah, let's see if we can replenish a bit. Now let's prevent them from sending reinforcements this way. Yeah, we can't get there just yet. If we go over here, we can jump over there. Okay, we can learn our two last technologies now. Ah, damn it, it lost a level. Let's fix this. Build that. And, yeah, Shaman's Hut should help. Yeah, because this place is corrupted with Skaven corruption. Good, we're building up our army. I think we'll soon be able to make a fifth army. No, a sixth army, and then send... Yeah, well, we're paying a ridiculously high price for every single army we have. And then send that this way. We're gonna send all of our armies this way at the end. And Azak will go here and attack from here. Yeah, Skarsnik will be here. Grimgor will probably be around here. Someone else will be here. And just take everything all at once. It's during a war.
Profit.
We might send Wurzak up here. and they'll start taking everything. It will be very quick. Yeah, that, why not? I think that's everything we can do this turn. Now we have some things to build. More money. Defenses. Actually, we should probably improve the defenses here in the Empire. Because this place is going to come under siege basically immediately. Yeah, because this place is going to come under siege immediately, so let's build up our defenses. Huh? Oh yeah, the Great Green Fort. Yeah, this place will have to defend itself against everything that the Empire is going to throw at us. And the Empire can throw a lot of stuff at us. So, let's see if they sally out to us. If they don't, and then we just attack them once we have our siege equipment ready. Shouldn't take too long. Three turns and then we can attack. Nagarond is on its last leg. That must mean that the High Elves won, right? Oh, no. Don't you dare. Okay, they sallied out to us. Okay, our reinforcements are much stronger than theirs. They have two artillery weapons. One of these things. Yeah. We're gonna have to send everything we've got at them. And just hope that we can drown them in the green tide before we drown in the vermintide. We'll send the expendable goblins in first, and the black orcs will come in second. And the goblins will tire them out, and the other guy... And then the black orcs will take care of whatever's left. Oh. Shit. Well, maybe it'll be this way then. Actually, you guys, over here, shoot them with the help of... the Arachnrock spiders.
Goblins.
Like this. Mine is this guy. Deploy them all here. Put Skarsnik here. Wizard over here. And we'll probably have to start this in slow motion. That's where the main army is coming from, the very dangerous one, the reinforcements. Attack, 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 kill that poison wind mortar, don't let it fire! Charge in. And bring one of these guys closer. Quick, get those rattling guns. All you guys, charge, charge, charge. Fast, fast, fast spell. Now. Okay, yeah, that should be all of our orders given. Okay, Skarsnik, this. Okay, I should probably slow things down a bit now, just to make sure that I'm doing everything correctly. Because there's a lot of orders that need to be given at the moment. Oh my god, look at all those guys. If one of them will blow up, that'll be really good. Where's our river troll hag? Okay, she's here. Keep her here. Send these guys over there. Send them away. Okay, everyone, charge! Prepare for the greatest barrage of loonies. Spinning loons ever. Yeah, this is the biggest spinning loon barrage ever. Don't let them fire! It'd be really good if I could actually see what's going on, but this is far too hectic of a fight to really see what's going on. Okay, cast a fireball that way, please. Okay, you guys fire into there. They have the explosion, I'm not sure why they're not using it. Where's Grimgor? Okay, he's there. Explode, please. Where's our wizard? Ah, we missed. Ed Bud! As much Winds of Magic as we can possibly get. Please kill the Dreadling Gun. Okay, yeah. Good, we're killing everything. Kill that weapon, please! We won't be safe until that weapon's gone. Grimgor, please. More spells. Push through! Push through! Some of our goblins are getting defeated. No big deal. I'll do it. As long as our Ragnarok spiders don't die. Good, good, good. We managed to obliterate one of their, one of their, whatever they're called. Their rattling guns. Okay, crap. Get this Ragnarok spider out of here. Oh, look at there! Damn it, we're too low on health. Okay, quick. Get the Arachnid Spider out of there. Get the Arachnid Spider out of there. Please break, 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 break. Don't die. Break, please break. Save the Arachnid Spider. Its life is more important than yours. Okay, that one there is dead. Okay, they start shooting us again. Who cares?
The war is here. The big war.
I think we're about to win.
Hear the great choice.
Obey.
Okay, where's our wizard?
I'll do it. Move it fast. Smell spec.
Okay, almost all of our units are dying there. Okay, Skarsnik, new plan of action, run away. Go get help. I think our spider... Yeah, I don't see a spider corpse anywhere, so it made out alive.
The lads are ready!
Okay, get those guys out of there. You want to use another one? Okay, that guy's immortal, so it doesn't matter. Okay, everyone die to protect Skarsnik and the rest. Don't just stand there! Kill! Where's Grimgor? Our units are getting wiped out because I can't really see what's going on. Don't break.
Going.
More was. We're winning. Doesn't matter if these guys get wiped out. Okay, yeah. There's Grimgor. I didn't want to click on that.
Let's do this.
They just stand there 5 feet in front of the thing they're supposed to kill and don't kill it. Okay, there we go. Army loss penalty, we win. I think one of our armies is almost completely destroyed, the other one... But I think all their armies are gone. For the most part.
Running.
I think most of their armies are gone.
Warlord of Eight Peaks.
Okay, drink your healing potions. Everyone that has a healing potion, please drink your healing potion now. We mostly took a lot of damage because our units just stood there like idiots taking damage. Which they just always do that, they just stand... Yeah, look. No, wait, that's the Black Orcs, but yeah.
Who wants ya? Wait for war! Shifting!
If I throw hay!
I don't think this one was wiped out. No, it wasn't.
Night goblins.
Cool that our archers managed to handle that situation there. Oh, those were the Teeth Breakers. So, or the special rattling gun. That was the special rattling gun.
Goblins.
Yeah, I think we. I don't see an Arachnorok spider corpse, so it's it survived. These guys are probably gone. These guys are gone, but they did really well against all those storm vermin. Yeah, wipe out everything you can. Those guys are wiped out. The Skarsnik too. Oh wow, Skarsnik has 95 kills. Skarsnik did really well. Oh no, stop attacking. It'll do so much more damage to my own units. Yep, it did a lot of damage to my own units. I don't think the other one was wiped out, but even if it was, it's not a big deal. Let's try and wipe out this last unit here and then end the fight. It'll also give her a little bit more time to regenerate. These guys weren't wiped out. Defense still alive. Oh wow. Oh yeah, it's the immortals. That's why they have so little health with all these entities. Because they have immortals. Entities can't die if they're above 50% morale. False victory, sure. I would have almost considered that a Pyrrhic victory, but okay. I think most of their dangerous units are gone. Yeah, okay, yeah, we lost a bunch of all of our goblins, basically. One quick hopper, and I think that's it. That's all we lost. But they've lost everything. Yeah. Yeah, we lost three goblins, one squeak hopper. This spider here won't make it alive if I... All the slings survived. Let's hope that we can win this next auto resolve then. Because that would be enough to have killed them. The problem was our units came in from a bad angle. Or actually a good angle to stop the other army. Not an ideal angle, however. Neither did their reinforcements, so it helped us a bit. But yeah, spinning loons are essential for dealing with Skaven. And dwarves, spinning loons are a really good ability. Yeah, we have 15 units left in this army. Seriously? Damn it, we're gonna have to bring some more reinforcements.
Get him!
Yeah, we're gonna have to bring in Wurzag as well.
The great green prophet.
Okay, you tell me if there's anyone in Darkhold. They're trying to make another army.
Impossible.
We won't let them. Want to build up these defenses. This could be a place for money. That as well. Because we're going to have to combat all this vampire corruption. And actually, it's almost it's going to be impossible to combat that vampire corruption. It's plus 50%. Not plus 50%, plus 50. Since plus 1 vampire corruption already causes this corruption to rise very quickly, that's going to be impossible to combat. And so that place is just going to be corrupted. One turn and these guys are ready. Then we can place them here and prepare for the invasion. They can't have that good an army, right? Yeah, just long beards and rangers is still a pretty good army. Not a doomstock, but still a pretty dangerous army that I don't want to mess with that. Okay, Grimgor leveled up. We need to get him to lightning strike. We need more points in Edbutt. More damage. And then more survivability as well, because she almost died. Let's do our last research technology, and then use all of our scraps for improving units. Two turns until this guy's ready, so we'll do the quest battle next episode, I guess. Yeah, that would be good to get the Dark Nimbus. Not orky enough. It would be important to get the Lightning Strike, though. Yeah, let's get to Lightning Strike. I don't really need evasion chance in the underway. Oh, damn it. That's gonna be annoying. It's going to reduce our... That could reduce our settlement level. Let's try and assassinate him before he destroys our settlement. Luckily, it's not a plague priest, but he could still make plague priests. And a plague right now would be the last thing we want. Okay, yeah. He's just wandering about. Oh, he's no threat to anyone anymore. How the hell did you recruit that many units? Look at how many units he recruited. He recruited 8 units. And we can now just auto-resolve him. That will most likely wipe out some of our units, but at this point, he's immortal. Yeah, I don't care. Mine. We really didn't need 2 Arachnarok spiders, but we'll just train another one. We'll just replace all those units. We have time. Skosnik's going to rest then, and while we finish off the Skaven.
You want schemes? I got schemes.
Can we train anything useful here? No. Yeah, we can. We can get some Doom Divers.
Goblin's angry!
We can get some Doom Diver catapults. Then we can get the 2 Arachnarok spiders. Once I can find them in here. Actually, okay, we need 2 Squig Hoppers as well. Nope, 2. Where is the Arachnarok spider? 2 of those. Oh no, just 1 of them. And the rest is just Night Goblin Fanatics. There, 5 turns and he's ready. Now Grimgor.
What?
Yeah, what?
Yeah, Grimgor needs to recruit for 1 turn, no, for 3 turns, another Black Walk.
I has my mystic powers.
We take this.
You can
occupy him. That's the last. Oh, no, it doesn't improve Arachnarok spiders. And we don't use spider riders. That's all useful, that's good.
I is invincibles.
That would help. Oh, we can't use that. Too many abilities already. Deadly Onslaught. Yeah, brings her over here. If they call in the Border Princess, I'll have to deal with that as well. Improve our income in any way possible. Okay, that's useless. This is much better. I think that's everything. No, we can still improve some other things. I don't really know what to build here anymore. So just build that. And this. Destroy that. Okay, that's everything. Ah, no, we will still be able to do the quest battle this episode. We'll end the episode with a quest battle. Okay, everything here is wrecked, but we'll fix it. Too bad that we lost a level here. Whatever. We can fix that very easily. We want to give us the extra growth. And it will rebel in 2 turns. That's good. We want that place to rebel quickly. So we can... Oh, look. Another Skaven army. We want that place to rebel quickly so we can crush a rebellion and then not have to worry about rebellions for a while. We're going to send Warzak to help finish off the Skaven. And then we're gonna do our final battle of the episode. The episode will run a bit over like 50 minutes, but not too long. Because we really need this item, whatever it is. Oh, it's his armor. Yeah, we need that, definitely. Oh yeah, that's very good, the mail defense. Instant reactivated, and the missile resistance, yeah, that's good. No, this involves sitting on ass waiting. Yeah, we'll go here. Claim Flayed Rock. Can this army claim Flayed Rock? Probably should start with Pick Barter. Aha, they did not destroy that thing yet. Let's wound him and hope we can get rid of him before he comes back. Yeah, you failed me. Edbert. Bring him over there.
What you want?
We could go finish these guys off. And now we can't. And they're not much of a threat. It seems to all be storm them. And we'll do this battle without the wizard. It's literally just this army that you see here. Nothing else. It's really easy. In most of the speech will probably be longer than the fight itself. Azag wasn't born yesterday. He don't know when he was born. Probably, like, a few decades ago?
Those stupid flouncy humans think they can trounce all over our sacred ground. That burial mound is Mork's property, not some fishy smelling lake hatch. Flippin' hat, stop whispering at me, I know! Come on, lads! We're gonna stamp these gits and send them running back to their pretty towers! I've had my vision! From Mork himself! He reckons we do this. It's gonna sort my armor out real good. And I won't have to knock you all about. What's that? Yes, we'll go south afterwards. Let's go. Let's kill some knights.
Well, Alec's going to be quite disappointed because there are no knights in this army. Only peasants. Only peasants here. No knights, just peasants. Okay, let's keep two of our guys in reserve to defend.
Show us the enemy.
And everyone else just charge forward. Everyone else charge forward like a lunatic. Send our monsters up this way. And send the Azog over there as well. We want to get rid of those catapults, they're the only dangerous thing they have. Everything else is harmless. Mounted yeomen, harmless. Those halberdiers, men-at-arms with pole arms, they're using billhooks, harmless. Billhooks are the poor man's version of a halberd. If you couldn't afford a halberd in medieval times, you bought yourself a billhook. Which was a repurposed farming tool. It actually made a very effective weapon. Very, very useful. It was a very good weapon in medieval times. And if you couldn't afford yourself a halberd, you could buy one of those. Yeah, and their catapults are being obliterated. And we're sending those Bretonian peasants straight to hell. With the purple son of Zarius. Okay, I send our monster over there. I really don't know what did all the damage, must have been the catapult.
That is the new dream.
Okay, yeah. Please try and hide. Send our idol over there. Oh, I said harmless and they're doing a crap load of damage. Well, I did say billhooks were useful weapons. And they do indeed have anti-large. And they do indeed have anti-large armor piercing damage, so of course they could do a bit more damage too. Azog than I'd be expecting. Not a big deal. They should really give the next game new animations. It's like in Three Kingdoms where there are different animations for different ways of being killed. Well, not everyone should explode in. Not everyone should explore in. Explode in blood and. In blood and guts. Especially not if they got frozen to death. If we're blasted with a spell that supposedly sucks the life straight out of them. There should be. Or was burned to death by dragon fire. There should definitely be multiple animations. I mean, there are some spells in here that just suck you into the void and you'll never see it again. And they should definitely have special animations. But I can understand if that's too much work. But they should at least implement a few different animations. Because it's just a bit lazy that everyone just explodes in guts. That's in blood when they get killed in this game. And no matter what it is that killed them. And sometimes they even sometimes their heads pop off when they get hit with an arrow. Or their arm pops off. It's ridiculous. Eat them. They're pretty scrawny because they're very poorly fed. Yeah, we can't get there anymore. Go over here. And going to armor stunts. More points into looter.
Time for the slaughter.
Okay, I don't know if they're in here or not, and damn it. The drag isles have been conquered by the. Well, I'm not gonna worry about those guys. Last defenders. They're a bit better than the Lizardmen are stronger than the Greenskins. By a lot, but they're still not. One of the most powerful factions there are. They have a very powerful Doom stack, but their economy is not the best. It's much better than Greenskin economy, but still, they're not the best faction there is. Okay, yeah, we want to... Yeah, sure, give us that. We want Dodgy Geezer, no. Spread public order. Actually, no. Yeah, it's still gonna rebel. We wanted the opposite of public order. Replenishment. And that's it for this episode. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time. Farewell.